Hey everyone, this is Jebro. This is a basically footage of Murdock during a game I had on a stream previously this week. Just wanted to go through it. I'm doing more Paragon stuff on my channel as well. I'm not doing just only Guild Wars 2, but this is going to be like a gameplay video commentary kind of thing, but also telling you about me learning and learning ADC, learning carries a lot more, because I've only really been playing them the last, 3 weeks or so. And I'm actually getting to the point now where they'll probably be my highest level. I'm still learning. I'm still learning to get good, I suppose. And this is not a video just for you guys, but for me to actually look back and think, okay, this is what I was like before, and now I'm going to be able to improve. So as a carry, my job is to go onto the red lane, to farm like an absolute boss, and to get the support to come with me. So the first thing I do in the game is say to Muriel, stop going on left lane with Grux. I need you to come to my right lane and come and support me as I farm up. That is what I do. I am a carry. I am weak at the beginning of the game and I start to get stronger and my damage will start to spike at some point in time. I'm still learning, as I said. So putting the trap down to make sure if anyone comes in for a potential gank, I'm not going to get absolutely wrecked. Because at the moment on the map, you can see that we have not got vision on quite a few of the enemies. You can see our Gideon is mid, you can see the Feng as well. And you can see that obviously a potential gank is coming out right now. But fortunately for me, my actual compadre, Muriel, is in the area. So that's good. So we're going to be actually absolutely fine right here. So we've got Countess and Gadget currently on this lane. I need to work on my last hits because I need to make sure I get them and I get my farm up. Missed that one and you could probably count how many more I missed. So this is me just being brutally honest. I'm not telling you I'm the best Murdock player in the world. I am trying to improve. And here I do... Yeah, I get one there. Okay, good. It's important to try... Look, I'm just waiting. I'm not doing damage. I'm just trying to wait for the minions to get as low as possible before I am able to, you know, last hit and get my maximum amount of card points I can. Muriel's taking all the punches at the moment. Unfortunately, I'll miss another one. But while we're trying to get the last hits, obviously making sure that Countess is not going to jump on me and do a ton of damage. She's going to be level 2. She might have a port now. It depends what she's taken. If she has, I find it unlikely that she maybe hasn't actually, to be fair. But doesn't look like she has. She's gone for an E. She's gone for a massive amount of damage there as well. So now we've got missing, getting the last hits. At least Muriel is getting them, so we share that, so it's good. And I've got a nice amount of card XP coming up. Card XP, obviously, is what I need to upgrade my and get my cards. Now, I eat a couple of the Countess's E's there as well, which is terrible, really. I need to make sure I'm never straight on from her, so make sure I avoid that AoE coming up onto me and my minions, sorry. You can see the blue areas, the traps that I've put down, obviously, if you play Paragon, then you know what they are. But they're going to slow the opponents coming up for a potential gank or even to just push me as well. So Muriel's pushed her right back, allowing me to farm and getting most of the last hits there as well. So that's good stuff. So what I tend to do now is I start to go for the focus on Countess, which is good. I miss my Q, unfortunately, which is going to do a lot of damage as well as the penetration. And here, I actually go onto the tower because I know I can get the kill, and that's really, really important. Now, what I have to remember is if there is any ranged mobs and minions left in the herd, they will start to target you. And at this level, you will potentially die quite quickly. So I lay a trap down there as well on this lane, to make sure maybe potentially someone's not going to come in for the gank. The one trap though is not enough. You can get around the sides of it. So I get a couple of last hits, risk it a little bit, move back, and here I should go to a jungle camp and just actually try and get, you know, there you go, I actually do. Try and get some farm up. Because if you're in the lane and you're not doing something, you're not farming. You need to make sure you're permanently farming, doing something to get yourself some last hits, some card XP, some level, to take the advantage. You know, that person's out of the fight for a while, they're not leveling up. Finn comes over and just drops a couple of hits. I jump and say hello, and also sorry. And you can see this camp is at level 2 now. After 2 minutes, those camps do level up to level 3. From 1 to 2 to 3, and they're worth a ton more card XP. Now, pros say, I believe, as I've heard, is that after about 4 or 5 minutes, it's not really worth taking level 1 camps. But I would say if you're a carry and you can't take anything else, then it's better than nothing. So I would actually take it myself, or at least, you know, because if you wait 2 minutes, that's 2 minutes of not doing anything. But Also, by that time, you could actually have had the lane pushed back against you anyway, and you could wait. So it's really up to you in the early game, but, you know, try and focus on getting those last hits, as I'm currently failing at the moment. I do get that one. Do I get that one? I do as well. So we're getting better. I'm slowly getting better at my last hits. Another thing I need to improve upon, which will be coming up very, very shortly as well, is my ultimate, my snipe. My sniping is flipping awful. I'm not gonna lie to you. Sometimes I get the more difficult clutch shots, but I don't get the really easy snipes, even sometimes the ones that are just sitting right in front of me because they can see me and I'm not very ninja about it, I guess. But here we go, you know, I'm trying to get my last hits. I'm getting them quite well, okay, at the moment. Muriel's died elsewhere. I've got some free farm. And the problem, one of the things you, like, people tend to think is that, shit, you know, the rest of my team is currently dying. What am I going to do, you know? Do I move off the lane? Do I stop farming? Here I go for a potential snipe. Do I get it? We do. We get the first snipe. So that's one out of one. And we do take the twin blast down. That's the carry on the opposite team. And he is actually on the wrong lane at the moment. He's on the solo lane with Greystone. And surprisingly enough, we've actually seen Rampage is actually doing absolutely fine. Unfortunately, I'm pushed so hard here that because I got the kill, I was being a bit cheeky. I didn't expect Chimera to come back. I've not got wards. I've not even got a trap there ready. I mean, I think he went through that trap, sorry. So really, there, I made a bit of a mistake. Luckily, I leveled up, and obviously by now you definitely would have leveled up your shield to bash Chimera away. So thankfully, I was okay there just about. So I activate my traps on the lane and I push back down. Now, I've still not got a ward. I need to back. I've got 9 points. There's too many. I should have backed when I had the lane pushed so far, and this was a mistake. But here I do something even cheekier, and I'm still trying to farm and get the last hits, even though we got missing. But I did see that they did, that Countess did actually back, or Chimera did actually back there. So I'm going to try and get the last hits. I'm actually going to try and get to 12 card points, which is fairly risky, but you can see how quickly it generates up. I can get last hits here, I can back and come back onto the lane and be at full cardix, have a nice ton of upgrades ready, and I will have a nice, just a nice spike of damage coming in. So I get that last hit. I missed another one or two there, so I messed up, which means that now I have to go into the jungle, waste more time to get another camp because I'm desperate. So I go to a camp, and of course it's level 1. So it's not going to give me as much as a 2 or 3, but I want to make sure I get to 12 when I go back because I'm so bloody close. Like, I would be kicking myself if I went back and I was so close to 12. But so here we go. This is why I'm doing it. So I feel like I should have backed before, but it's okay at the moment. We got a kill on Twin Boss as well. I'm just going to immediately back. The lane is pushed. Chimera is there on the right hand side. You can see also Feng is there as well. I back. Chimera is potentially coming down, but way too late. Now, I'm on the lane on my own mostly. Not everyone will get wards. Normally, the support should get the wards. So I get these wards. I pick up the ward and I fill out my card, my damage card as well. Now, that's a level 2 card. Just FYI, with 1 and 2 slot upgrades. Sorry, I'm gonna have to go back through the footage and actually make sure that's right, because I have changed my build a bit recently, but I'm just doing commentary at the moment. So it's important to have those low level cards that give you those quick upgrades. So the big combos, they're gonna be able to, you know, those completed card sets that give you, you know, the extra damage bonus or health bonus, depending on which class you are. Luckily enough, I'm in time to make sure the town's gonna be okay. I can continue to farm and all is well and good. So, I've got my wards. When I push back through this set of minions, I can place down those wards and I can farm even safer. Hopefully I can get them a little bit deeper than I normally do. But still, that's risky because obviously Chimera is hanging around. I stick down a trap as soon as I possibly can to make sure the cooldown's going to come off quick so that I can put another trap down. But before I even push over the midpoint, and I do put a ward there as well. I need to make sure. So they've got a ward. My ward has just brought up their ward. So I need to try and kill it at some point. I needed to kill it quicker. But the thing is, I couldn't push because I didn't know where people were. And she's seen my ward as well. So also, if I'd pushed over there and tried to get the ward, I probably would have got taken out by Countess, which is another reason why I didn't do that. Because being aware that she's around is, you know, something that's very important, because she can port on you, she can ult you, and she can take you down really low, especially since I've got no health at the moment and I really need to get some ASAP. So, last hitting as much as I possibly can at the moment is very, very, very important indeed. And every single minion is going to mean... So, that's a miss there. Is this a miss? I'm waiting. No, we got that one. Jesus Christ. So now it gives me the opportunity, now that lane is pushed in my favour, not in my favour, but it's pushed through away from the tower, I can kill the ward, and that's really good, because now it means that my jungler can come over, potentially for a gank, and she knows she's not got ward, so she's not going to be as aggressive as she would like to. Again, I eat so many of these casts from Countess, it's just ridiculous. It's always the same with Countess. I think no matter which hero I'm playing, I always seem to fail in terms of my positioning on that. And that's the thing with a carry as well. You need to be so well positioned. So when I'm talking about learning, here's another snipe. This is going to be 2 of 2. I got the hit. So it's damage. That counts. Does that count? I don't know. So I can still farm quite freely. This is what's nice about being on this lane on my own versus one other. Unfortunately, I failed that last hit just a little bit late there, and that one. So that's a load of farm. 3 minions, unfortunately, on the last hits. Now, you've got to make sure you time that well with the tower, because it just goes boom, boom, and then if there's minions there as well, they'll suddenly burst it down, which is what happened 2 or 3 times there. So I am aware of that. Don't need to point out the fact that I failed on quite a few minion last hits, but the worst thing would be if I'm failing them more than the opposite team's carry, so the Twin Blast. Thankfully, I've actually been alive the whole game so far, thus far, and Twin Blast has actually died once. So odds are, obviously at this time, I'm probably ahead in farm in terms of that as well. So, you know, the good thing about having a support on your lane as well is that they can definitely secure probably last hits, because they'll go for them if you're not. And most of the time you'll probably get, because you share that XP, that card XP, obviously, you know, it's always pretty nice to have a support. But in this case, I just haven't been able to, because Twin Blast, and obviously we had Greystone and others on that left lane. You can't really put just one guy against there. So, you know, Muriel is just drifting between mid and left at the moment, mostly. So yeah, just keep farming. I keep laying down the traps as well, because they do run out over time, and unfortunately it looks like Muriel's gone down on the other side of the map as well. Even though Grux is quite pushed, they do have wards there, and both of us have wards there at the moment. Grux pulls back, which is a good idea for him to do. So still farming, still trying to get the last hits, just waiting until the last hit, even if I've got a ton of damage, just making sure I 100% get that, because sometimes I underestimate the fact I've actually got, you know, a fair bit of damage. So I even hit a minion to the point where, you know, I don't always fully kill it, and then I'm waiting to, you know, reload my gun, and then I fire again, and the minion's already dead. So remember, there is like a cooldown for you, or just your normal ability. A second, 1 second, 1 second, 1 second, you know. So make sure you're timing that with everything, with towers getting the minions, with your minions hitting the minions, also the ranged minions and whatnot as well. I've got my ult, we're going to see if we can go for it. It's going to be a blind one. I've hit something, it's not him though. So unfortunately, we got 1 kill out of the 3 snipes. Not great. But at least I've gone for it, you know. Use the chances. Just keep practicing, because that's the only way you're going to get better at that. Don't rush it. You know, that was potentially a bit of a waste, but I thought, you know, I might be able to get a bit of a cheeky kill there. While I'm trying to actually communicate with my team, I'm missing my farm. So I'm trying to command the game as well as probably get a bit salty at times, which is sometimes the way I get in Paragon. It's not the only game it happens in, I'm not gonna lie. But don't try not to be salty, because you miss your farm like me. But actually, that was me just pointing out something on the map as well. I've got 6 points there on the map. Someone just subscribed to the twitch.tv/JebroUni. There you go, a little bit of an advertisement. But yeah, I'm farmed. Starting to get more farm, putting the trap down. I've got no wards. Now, this is risky as hell. Twin Blast is dead again, so I'm definitely ahead of him. Just trying to get those last hits, push this wave onto the tower. It's in our favor, you know. It's slow push to a degree, because there's a couple of minions down in there, the minion set that's actually pushing the tower. I know this camp is definitely at level 3, for sure, and now I can get a shed load of card XP, which is awesome. So last hitting, obviously, is, you know, no one else is going to come in and do that, other than, you know, junglers and whatnot. So that's really good for me. Pushed a ton of minions onto the tower. It's really low. Now, what do I do here? I've got no wards, oh, we're just going to go in and try and get the kill on the tower, probably, or actually just kill the minions, make sure we get the last hit, see the actual player coming in there as well, and look who it is. We don't want to mess with that counter, so we're backing off for sure there. Just picking up all the amber we can as we go back, even just pulling off a cheeky couple of hits there. Can see another kill has come out, so there's one potential ganker out of the map. He's been on the left for ages. I know she's back in, so I pull her out of that and get a ton of damage on her. That's going to stop her now, because that's one thing I like to use the snipe for. If I can see that someone's backing, it's now completely delayed her spawn time back into the map. She's got to go back, she's got to regen her health, she's got to get her cards up, because she might be back in to get cards, and then she's got to come back to the tower. Look how low the tower is. The tower is so low that I can get something out of this, and that is absolutely perfect. So that was, I like the play I pulled out there, and I should be able to get this tower, and it will go down indeed. So I've actually pulled out a nice tower kill there, so I'm quite happy with that. We got mid and right down. So now I've got 9 card points. I'm very, very close to getting 12. Again, I feel like if the opportunity came, I could have backed earlier and maybe used those card points. And actually, this point in time, I did something wrong. I should have gone and leveled up. And I'm punching myself in the face right now. And you can't see it, thankfully. You can see me on the screen. But I want to hit myself, because I made a massive mistake. So I'm going for a whirling one there. So I'm building attack damage and energy damage. At the moment, and a lot of damage. I'm not even building really much health at the moment either, to be honest. So we are going to roll back into the map. I'm not really talking about the cards, I'm more talking about my gameplay here more than the cards. I'll do a card build in the future, but I'm just kind of trying to learn and talk for it almost myself. So this video is almost for myself more than it is for you, which is kind of funny, but obviously it's going to my channel, so it's for you. Unfortunately, I backed. Countess has got ridiculous amount of wave clear as well, and I screwed up there. I should have got out quicker. I was taking way too long to put my cards in. I was thinking about it a bit too hard. I've got my stream on as well. It's not an excuse, but did lose the tower. At least we got one of theirs. We have got a couple of kills. I'm looking for a potential snipe here. I need to be a bit quicker because I'm missing my farm. I come back up and I've potentially missed some minion kills. I don't think I have. I think I picked that moment okay in the end, so it's not too bad. But I'm just pointing out my own mistakes is really going to help like my gameplay. So if you actually have some kind of feedback or comments, then that's always useful. I'm hoping to cast a lot more of Paragon as well. So I know what to do in the back of my head. But then again, you know, it's quite difficult. The reason is I kill that end minion there is to slow push the lane, because I want to make sure that that lane is going to be slow pushing. So to slow push a lane, if you don't know this, you kill the ranged minions because they're the ones that do the most damage, or a ton of damage. I know we've obviously got siege minions as well. But that is very, very important to do if you want to slow push your lane. So I've just left that to push very, very slowly, because I know now I need to start getting into fights if there's team fights, because I'm going to be able to carry some of these with the amount of damage and the amount of farm I've got, and the fact that I'm actually quite a few card XP levels above the Twin Blast, and I could probably get some kills. So I go to mid, I push the mid tower over. Right lane, you can see, is getting pushed slowly but surely. That is very much slow push. Those minions will die, and then the ones coming up behind it will make a bigger group, and it will continue to steamroll onto that right tower. So keep your eyes on the top right hand corner of the map unless I go back, because that will slowly start to get to that right hand tower. On the left hand side, Gadget is pushing. No one is defending. We should lose that. That's an unfortunate thing there. I potentially could have gone over that to that side of the map, but you know, I can see that the thing is there. Why he has not gone over to defend, and this is a classic mistake in solo queuing in silver and gold. No one wants to go and defend. Grux is coming back. Feng should have just replaced him on lane until he got back. Luckily, they're going to get back there just in the nick of time. Maybe not. And we should be okay. So now I'm versus the carry in lane with a melee, with obviously, you know, the push coming out from Greystone. Luckily, I don't know why I pulled out the shield there. I think it was to try and make sure the minions weren't going to come onto me. But Twin Blast got quite a nice amount of hits. He's not got as much damage as me, and he is actually a lot lower level than me. He's two levels below as well, and I'm getting some nice hits on Greystone, poking him as well very well. And we see, obviously, teammates coming in. I'm focusing on the Greystone because he's in range, simply enough. Bash him away with my shield, of course, to make sure he's not going to be able to get in, so I can kite him around. And I'm going to take him, hopefully here, into his ult. So obviously, you know, he's got second life. Gideon has taken the Twin Blast down, and now I can really push onto the Greystone. Now this is risky because all the minions here as well, and I know I have to back off. Luckily for me, Fane comes in, and I knew that they were going to be able to help me and defend. You have to be gutsy at times, but you know, that was very, very risky. And if he hadn't have been aware, then I would have got wrecked there and I would have died. Unfortunately, Muriel is going to die in the jungle there as well. I could have stayed and just offered a bit of range support, but they're fine. They're out of the fight. I need to back. I need to build up my cards. And here I grab a little bit, not a little bit, three major casts. So attack speed and two major casts. So I'm building my attack speed and my damage. I'm not building any crit. Crit is not good in the game at the moment. I've spoken to various people. Apparently numbers are all wrong for it. If you're building crit, just don't. It does work. I don't know why it does and doesn't work exactly, but apparently the numbers are wrong. Apparently the way crit works, it's not great. Like it's better to build like damage and like maybe attack speed as well, depending, but not a massive amount, obviously, because you just want to have that main bulk of damage, the sustained damage there as well. So if you're building crit and you're not building damage, and crit isn't working as it's intended to be, and it's not great, and it needs to be buffed or whatever, then you know that's bad. And at the moment I'm doing something which is very bad. Obviously I've not got a tower here, thankfully. I've got a Muriel, which sometimes, you know, is really, really good, because you are able to push, and if you know they've actually got their ult. But I didn't know that, you know, that wasn't something where I was fully aware of what was happening. And here we've got a really good, like, shout out to this thing, because he is an absolutely hero. Him and Muriel just saved my ass completely. Got two kills, and that's what my job is, to finish the fights, to get the kills down. There's the red buff there as well. I think another one drops here somewhere. I do type it as well, another red exclamation mark. But unfortunately, the thing, it just wants to move on and move through the jungle again and move back. So we've got jungle camp here, level 3 black. Now 22 minutes in, getting the black buff, and first time really, is not great. I should have got it way earlier. But really, there wasn't a great opportunity to do that. There were times, but with the Chimera and also the Greystone at mid, and this is another funny mistake right there. You see how I've pushed the right tower over? You see how I went to the black camp? This is why I wanted to bring this video in as well, because I will show you my bloody mistakes, and I do not care about them, because I will learn. I just killed the black buff minions, right? What did I forget to pick up? Answers on the postcard. If you didn't get that and you're thinking about it, I'll give you another 20 seconds or so before we actually move on to this tower. So I'm pushed up quite far. Look how many wards I don't have right now. I've got one right in the middle. If anyone comes up the left side of me, I'm screwed. If anyone comes up from the bottom mid side of me, I might not be screwed, but someone from mid might potentially come in towards the right-hand side lane. Now, Chimera's there, and so is Countess as well. I've pushed those minions so far that they go for me instead of going for the tower. Then they get confused. You can't get confused. You go for the kill or you go for the tower. You make decisions, and you live by them. Unfortunately, they screwed up. The tower went down and I got out. I should not have got out of a fight where I'm less than half HP, 50% HP, and the fact that Countess and also Chimera can wreck me, and probably in like a stun and an ult, and I'm dead. Want to know what I forgot to pick up? I didn't pick up the black buff. So that tower would have been down before they would have even got there. So again, I get lucky. I get lucky quite a few times in this game, so I get saved. But it's a really good game to give you a perspective of yourself and your own gameplay. Which mistakes do you make? I know you make mistakes, like awful mistakes, and you just think, God, why did I do that? I just sucked at that moment in time. I'm not going to admit it, though. You know, I'm sorry, guys. I screwed up, you know. I'm just going to hold my hands up above my bald head and just admit it right now. I fucked up a few times. It happens. This is what happens when you're learning. The problem I have with people not trying to learn and actually get better is that. I don't, you know, that's the problem. And that is a lot of what goes on in Paragon at the moment, especially in the gold to silver level. The matchmaking as well isn't that solid. You know, they widen the brackets. I think it was all data mined and whatnot as well. So you're put with, you know, less skilled or more skilled people than you currently. So I might go up against tougher players, might go up against very much weaker players, which is very much the case at the moment. Muriel has died quite a few times. Now, I will say this for nothing. It's not that bad because she can die as long as she's giving us support to push the fight and win the fight and we get more kills. We get two kills out of the fact that Muriel dies and she offered the support that saved the damage dealers and the rest of our team at the time. So that's the important thing to remember and realize about the support. So that's not too bad. We got two kills, Muriel died, but that means that now I can go and farm, we can go and get jungle camps. I keep calling them dungeon camps. And just helping people out. I can see obviously on the left lane that no one else has gone to defend and I call for a careful on mid as well as realizing that that tower's gone down. So I wait, go in, clear the enemy and put a sarcastic good job in for some reason. I think I was pretty pissed off there actually. Oh no, it's because we actually got a kill, lol. Damn it, I'm trying to stop doing the sarcastic good jobs. You know how I feel. We've done it at some point in time. Even if it's just as a joke, like I do not want to do that anymore. Do not do that anymore. I am not trolly as a player, but I get angry. I get very angry. And I don't think it happens in this game, but I do. I get pissed off. I type in the chat sometimes. Not sometimes, every game. I do sarcastic good jobs. And that's really shitty. Like, don't do that. I do that from time to time. And I don't like it. And I don't like the person I become when I start to lose. So if you don't want to trigger me, don't just do silly things. I do silly things as well, and I screw up, but I say sorry for it. So if you know you screwed up, just say sorry, and I guarantee you that someone will forgive you somewhere, even if it's not the players that are currently playing with you. I'm just being brutally honest. This is what I'm like in my videos. I'm not going to bullshit you and try and give you top end, top plays, but I'm trying to give you the mistakes that I'm making. I've said that a few times now. So we've got towers pushed. Inhib on the right is kind of free at the moment, you know. We could actually get a nice hit up here. But there is a big team fight mid. I will tell you right now that we do not, in this game, no, actually I'm not going to give you spoilers, but I need help, I need assistance. But now, I'm not caring about last hits, I just want to clear the wave. That's all I want to do. But Feng's there as well, chances are we get the last hits, there's also Gideon there as well. Jungle fight coming up, this could be a big one, it could actually be a game-ending fight, this very fight right here. But I'm telling you to be careful, I'm pushing and focusing on the lane, they're all going for black. All going for black right now. Gadget comes in, misses her ult, completely screws up. She gets the speed gate down and gets away. I avoid it completely, but you can see what they're doing. They're running after. Oh my god, Mr. Chuck needs to run away hard here. Muriel is going to be okay because obviously she's in travel, not in travel mode anyway. She can give herself a nice boost and move forward. Are we going to be able to get here in time? I'm very aware about the fact that two players could just jump on me, I could get a stun, and then Twin Blast could come up to me as well and just wreck me. So I run away, and they actually chase me for a significant amount of time. They screwed up here. This is one of the many times they've grouped up, they've tried to deathball, whereas the rest of the lanes upon me and the mid and whatnot are starting to get pushed back. Not enough. It does mean they can come into this lane now. So we've got 3 versus 2 currently. We've got Feng coming in. Sorry, Muriel as well. And it looks like we might be okay. But look! Oh, the Muriel has made such a massive mistake there. And where's my sarcastic good job? Anyone? No, don't do it. No one does it because we know that it's, you know, it's just probably unlucky. But Gideon comes in, not expecting someone else to make the same mistake, and I can lay down a ton of damage here as well. Feng does a nice ult, and obviously, you know, at that point in time, I needed to get out of the Greystone ult, because he comes down and just takes a massive chunk. Obviously, Twin Blast is fairly weak at the moment, and we are doing a ton of damage. Pick up the kill on that young man there as well. Minions have gone down. Gadget, I missed my snipe. No! If I just waited. Patience is very, very much a virtue in that situation. I wish I had waited. to make sure that I would have got that kill, because that would have been nice as well, and we could have definitely gone for the win. But the thing is, right now, we're so far at the end of the game that we are potentially going to be able to win as well. Three kills, Muriel, like I said, is dead again. In this case, probably didn't need to die, but the Chimera picked up that kill very nicely. So now I'm at 6 points, 6 card points. I'm going to get myself to 9. And normally I think I would back, but look at what we've got on the map. 3 kills. We need to take advantage of this. We need to take advantage of this. Is it 4? 3 or 4 kills? I can't remember now. So we can at least get a tower out of this. I've got black as well, so it's going to go down fast. There's no one who's going to be able to come in and do a ton of damage. It is 3 kills because Countess is left as well. And Grux was 1v2 there. So Gadget should be coming in here at some point in time. The rest of the players as well, they are very low, so I know that they can't push with me if I want to push, and that, you know, it just would not be a good thing to happen whatsoever. So they're going to regroup, they're going to retreat and go back to base. I'm going to get to the tower and base back. I should have found a shadow pad and done it somewhere else, because it would have been quicker. But we've still got to watch out for mid, because, you know, can push that lane very quickly if everyone backs. Like, backing at the same time as everyone else, especially early games, like, really, really bad. But it's not too bad now, because we've got lanes pushed in our favour. I can go back and get my Blink Charm. I can discard my lower level card and build some health or extra damage. But because I know I'm getting so many kills and I have not died, I don't really build much health. You can see, other than my Staff of Adamant, I'm building damage. I did get and realize that I can actually fill up my meltdown as well and then put a health card in, and I think screw it, you know. I know I'm going to lose that damage bonus from this staff, but I can get the damage bonus for the meltdown if I get rid of that one, and then I can get the extra health card. So I think I'm going to get a ton of extra health and damage through that, and that was a good way to go. We're level 14, 51 card points at the moment. We are pretty far ahead of the Twin Blast. Oh, he actually disconnects there as well. So this is actually a disconnect on their side, and it looks like he could have rage quit. So did we make this guy rage quit? Potentially. I think we did. So really, that's the end of the game. There you go, guys and girls. That's how we won in the end. But we were gonna, that was on that fight as well where he disconnects. So he actually did rage quit. I think he came back, but I think at this point in time, and I didn't want to give you spoilers, that we did actually in the end win this game. They did just surrender, because I think that was one of the main problems. And actually, that's a really good point to make. Funnily enough, I don't actually remember that happening, like looking at the screen and thinking, oh god, he's, you know, he's rage quit. Or maybe I did, I can't remember during the stream. I could just turn on the audio and you'd find out. But the fact that he got wrecked so much, like, can make you tilt hard. As a carry, if you die so much at the beginning of the game, you are seriously screwing up your team's potential to win. Really badly, because you need to be carrying those team fights later on. You need to be involved in getting a ton of sustained, full-on auto attack damage in that fight, as well as, you know, your other abilities which give you damage. But obviously, you know, your main damage and your sustain is coming from your main auto attack, so you need to make sure that you're leveled, you've got those cards to give you that damage that you need to push through the game to win it for your team. If you are dying all the time, you're getting ganked, you haven't got wards, you know, your support is just being rubbish and not helping you out. So if you're a support player, help your damn carry, man. Get into that lane with him. And if not, you know, equal it up on other sides. But, you know, jungler as well, coming for ganks, help the guy to get kills so that he can level up faster. He can gain his XP, obviously, and farm as well on the lane. Help him out, because if he's struggling and he's behind their carry and you get into team fights towards mid and late game, or just before that as well, you know, early to mid game as well, he's not going to help you. He's not going to be able to help you at all compared to the other carry. He's going to be doing a ton of damage. So this game, obviously, like I said, really is one at the moment. So I really want you to give me some kind of feedback. Anything else that you think would be useful for me or anyone else in the comments below. I will be doing a lot more videos like this, you know. I'm not as experienced as, say, you know, the top end players of the game, but I am casting the game now, and my knowledge of the game and also is, you know, getting a lot better. I'm starting to actually really, really enjoy the whole, you know, the whole game, just in a massively different way. If you get yourself into the, to a point where you want to learn about, you know, the cards, getting to the point where you want to know about, you know, all the stat bonuses, all the different little tiny things like, you know, the wombo combos, like all these important things which make you a better player, all these important things, you know, okay, why do I go over this card over that card, you know, building a smaller card set at the start of the game, why do I do that, you know, rather than just starting off with, say, you know, I don't know, a Windcarver blade with like three major kinetics or something to give you a ton of attack speed when you've got no damage. Why are you doing that? Like, all these different things, there's so many little things in this game to know, it's difficult as a new player. So if you're a new player as well and you're kind of learning with me and trying to get some kind of info about how you can improve, watch videos, go to the twitch.tv, have a look at Paragon players. There's top end players. Don't just go watch your favorite streamer, go and watch the top end players and ask them questions, because they will help you. That is what I am doing right now. I'm going to the iCamerons from Oxygen, I'm going to the guys from Carbon, Reborn, anyone who will listen to me, you know. Some of them don't know who I am, but I just ask in their chat random questions. I know some of the Oxygen guys now and the Carbon boys as well. So ask questions, ask me questions in the comments. If I don't know the answer, I'll find it out. But I'm getting better, and hopefully the next video I will show you, I'll get even better. I got 9 kills in that. I got 0 deaths. What did you get? See you in the next video. Thanks for watching. Take care. That is a change around right there. A good orb defense there from the Bloods groupies. Means that they potentially pick up a tower here, but they need to be careful. Oh, comes out! Oh, that's a lot of damage. But are they again being too much onto the towers? It kills them as well as Murdock and the rest of this triggered Salt Miners team. Ah, oh, Nate, what did they do wrong there?
I mean, they went to push the answer. I mean, they went to push the tower. They had enough minions to probably take the tower down by sending one man. They sent 3 men. Wacko came in late. Murdock came up behind him, basically put the gun to the back of his head and pulled the trigger.